right, we're going to get this show going. There'll be minimal talking because we do have a packed service for you. We have 14 different performances. So this is going to go quick in between performances. So up now we have Haley McCusker performing the song Who Knew, written by Ben Bush. This is for the songwriting category. Fine arts allows people to write songs even if they can't particularly play an instrument or sing. They allow someone else to perform it for them there. So this is Ben Bush. Stand up one more time, Ben. Where are you at? No, you're not. There he is. All right. On the deck is Madison Campbell, her drama solo. And in the hole is Small Drama, Tweedle Goobers. All right, here we go. This is Who Knew?
Oh,
Awesome. Awesome job. Awesome job. Yeah, so that, again, that is Ben. And Ben wrote that song. One more time, Ben, stand up. Yeah. Good job, buddy. So another category that students can participate in at Fine Arts is called Drama Solo. This drama solo is going to be performed by Madison Campbell. So if she's ready, awesome. And then up next is the Tweedle Goobers. All right, Madison.
So lately, I've been thinking about the word limitless and what that means to society as a whole. And what would happen if everything that was supposed to be limited wasn't? Let's look at some examples, shall we? Like, love. Oh, darling Josh. Oh, I love you so very much. You mean the world to me. We only dated for a week, but it was the best week of my life. How can it be that you're gonna leave me for that hussy Vanessa Ann? Whatever her last name is, doesn't matter. She's a meanie for stealing my hunky man. Wait till she hears what I gotta say about this. I'm gonna get her phone number. Or, exercise. Pastor Wes, come on, drop down and give me 20. Good night. everything. So let's learn to live within limits for a limitless God.
Awesome work. Awesome work. All right, now I got a real treat for you next. All right. This small drama group is called the Tweedle Goobers. That's right, the Tweedle Goobers. You are up. I do want to make a quick note. Everything that you hear in this drama does actually exist in real life, so just keep that in mind.
Pretty good. What have you been to? Jennifer Aniston.
Welcome to Speed Dating. You have a few moments to talk to your future date. If you're interested, hit the buzzer. If not, move on. We'll begin at 3 and 2 and 1 and go.
Hi, my name is Nick.
Hi, do you want to be a snowman? Huh? Huh? Say yes. Say yes. Say yes.
No, it's 80 degrees outside and let it go.
Cause baby, you're a firework. Come on, show me what you were. Come on, baby.
Sometimes we get so caught up in our relationships, or even the fact that we're single, that we forget who our one true love should be, and that's Jesus Christ.
We often put our confidence in our relationships. We need to keep Christ at the center of our lives, and all else will fall into place.
I want to encourage you to pray about your current relationship, or if you're single, be praying for your future spouse.
Don't date to just date. The purpose of dating is to find the one you will spend the rest of your life with. Date with purpose and conviction in pursuit of a
limitless love.
Great work, great work. So all the 8 to 12-year-olds in the room say, man, youth group's not that scary. I'm excited to go now. See, that's my secret goal. I'm recruiting. No, I'm just kidding. Great job, guys. So up next, we have a dramatized quoting performed by Haley McCusker. So what this is a passage of scripture that is quoted kind of as if you were the person or someone connected to it, okay? So that's what's going on. I'd also like to take this time to remind anyone doing spoken drama on our team, you must stand in front of the red line, please. Thank you so much. We have Haley McCusker, dramatized quoting.
I'm going to be quoting Psalms 139, verses 1 through 24, New King James Version. O Lord, you have searched me and know me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You understand my thought afar off. You comprehend my path and my lying down and are acquainted with all my ways. For there is not a word on my tongue, but behold, O Lord, you know it all together. You have hedged me behind and before and laid your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high, I cannot attain it. Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I go into heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, you are there. If I rise in the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall fall on me, even the night shall be light about me. Indeed, the darkness shall not hide from you. For the night shines as the day, the darkness and the night are both alike to you. For you formed my inward parts. You covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are your works, and that my soul knows very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in secret and skillfully wrought in the lowest parts of the earth. For your eyes saw my substance, being yet unformed, and in your book they all were written, the days fashioned for me, when as yet there were none of them. How precious also are your thoughts to me, O God! How great is the sum of them! If I were to count them, there would be more in number than the sand. And when I awake, I am still with you. Oh, that you would slay the wicked, O God. Depart from me, therefore, you bloodthirsty men. But they speak against you wickedly. Your enemies misuse your name. Do I not hate those, O Lord, who hate you? And do I not loathe those who persecute you? I hate them with perfect hatred. I count them my enemies. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my anxieties. And see if there is any wicked way in me. And lead me in the way everlasting.
Awesome job. Excellent work. All right, up next we have a duet vocal for you. This is Walk on Water, performed by Brianna and Leslie Nestor. Here you go.
Your love.
So what are you waiting for? What do you have to lose? Your insecurities trying to alter you. You know you're made for more, so don't be afraid to lose. Your faith is all it takes in you to walk on the water too.
All right. As you can see, we got a broad range of categories already. Ooh. Solo drama, Pastor Justin. No, I'm just kidding. You wouldn't want to see that. All right. So up next, we have a drama solo performed by Ashley Harris. Senior High, Large Human Video is on deck. Get ready.
Warning, what you're about to see and hear is completely true. Viewer discretion is advised. And again, I'm not making any of this up. You've been warned. Look at this. I mean, just look at this. It's my new pet chinchilla. I mean, sure, I love the fluffy little guy, but you see, I'm not very good with animals. Every animal I've ever had always ends up in some sort of tale of woe. Like what happened to my turtle 2 months ago. Ah, oh, Shelly, you're just the cutest little thing ever. I love you, I love you. You want to be my best friend? Do you? Do you? Aw. Now you wait here, little fella. Mama's going to leave this nice heat lamp on for you so you can get a cute little turtle fan, okay? And remember, Mommy loves you. Okay, I'll admit, I was gone longer than I said. I was gone more for like 45 minutes. And when I got back, it was not pretty. I'm back! How's Mommy's little angel? Shelly! How did your eyeballs melt? Shelly, I think you're dead! Okay, I'll admit, Shelly the turtle did die a long and very painful death. In fact, I think I'm the reason why the ASPCA made all those commercials with this particular song in it. They're in the arms of the angels that way. You get the idea. Well, what happened to my pet turtle was not nearly as bad as what happened to my pet fish. All right, Gilbert, you're just gonna go in your nice new little tank right there, okay, little fella? I'm gonna put you in there. Okay, now, to keep a fish pool clean, let me think. I put a whole cup of chlorine in my pool to keep it clean, so half a cup of chlorine in the fish bowl will work out just perfectly. Go, nice and sparkly. Now I'm gonna go watch some TV. About 15 minutes later, I've noticed a very bad smell emanating from the back of my room. Naturally, I went to go investigate. What is this? What is going on? Oh no, not again! I accidentally poisoned Gilbert! What is wrong with me? I am a horrible, horrible, horrible person! Okay, that wasn't so good. And after all the failures with the aquatic pets, I decided to switch to something maybe more durable. So I got mammals. And that meant I got a hamster. Oh, Robbie, you're just the cutest little thing ever. I love you so much. Ow! Robbie bit me! That's it, you're going in your hamster ball. There. No, Robbie, don't you dare go down the stairs. I mean it. Don't go down the stairs. Dead serious. Well, once again, about another half hour later, I heard this horrible thump, 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 crash. And I looked from the top of my stairs, and in my wall was a hole shaped like this. Robbie decided he wanted to meet my pet turtle and fish that day. But despite all the tales of woe that befell my pets, there is a message behind it. That God loves us even more than we realize. He won't leave you out under a heat lamp too long or poison your water supply or let you fall down the stairs the equivalent of a 10-story building. He loves us, and when we have problems, he tries to provide us solutions to those problems, even if they're not in ways that we would normally expect. After all, he takes care of the birds of the air and the plants on a daily basis. He could do the same for you. He even sent his one and only son to die for us. He cares for us so much. And that means a lot to a person like me, considering all the mistakes I make on a daily basis. Well now, Chili, it's time I told you a new story. The story of my dog named Pepper. You see, though, he has gender problems. We have to call him Pepperina now. Bye-bye, folks!
Excellent work. All right. Senior high, large human video. Go ahead and get in position. Words cannot express how proud I am of this team. The practicing that they have put in is just crazy. You can get in position, that's fine. The practicing they have put in is so intense. I mean, multiple practices per week, 4 to 6 hour practices. Their coaches have been relentless with getting this video where it is today. I am also proud to announce that this was the second highest scoring showcase at Fine Arts this year. So they did very, very well, and I couldn't be more proud of them, so I hope you enjoy.
The hand of the Lord was upon me. He brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. He led me back and forth among them, and I saw a great many bones on the floor of the valley. He asked me, "Son of man, can these bones live?" I said, "O sovereign Lord, you alone know."
You do know, God. I feel alone in my walk with you, spiritually drained and dead. I want to be like Ezekiel, unwavering in faith and vision. Instead, I find myself more like Samson and Elijah during their seasons of weakness.
By Elijah and a strong wind, earthquake, and fire came. But the Lord was not in them, but instead in a gentle and quiet whisper. God still strengthens his children as we wait in his presence, allowing the breath of God's Spirit to fill us with limitless power. Power that restores us just as he will one day restore Israel, physically, emotionally, and spiritually, creating a mighty army. He gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, he increases strength. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint.
Then he said to me, prophesy to these bones and say to them, dry bones, hear the voice of the Lord. I will make breath into you and you will come to life. Then you will know that I am the Lord. So I prophesied as I was commanded, and as I was prophesying, there was a noise, a rattling sound, and the bones came together, bone to bone. I looked, and tendons and flesh appeared on them, and skin covered them. No breath in them. Then he said to me, prophesy to the breath and say to it, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe into these slain that they may live. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and breath entered them. They came to life and stood up on their feet, a vast army.
Come on, give it up for him. I cannot wait for nationals to see that. But we got to get them there. That's what tonight's for. So, man, that's good. That's good. I encourage y'all, read the story of Elijah. Man, oh man. Powerful stuff. All right, so we're going to shift gears here. So up next, we have a piano solo performed by Leslie Nestor. Ready? Come on, give it up for Leslie. Swerve. That was beautiful. All right, up next, we got a sermon. You're in church, right? No one's excited about a sermon? This is a short sermon performed by Madison Campbell. Madison is one of my seniors this year, which is a wonderful thing and a sad thing, because I guess I'll be losing her to this stuff. As she goes to pursue what God has for her, but I am so proud of her. Please give her your attention.
Thank you. So today, I'd like to speak to you on purpose. And I think a good example of this is the life of Rachel. And so I'd like to just kind of summarize that, because it's a bit of a long story. And you'll find it in Genesis 29, verses 14. What happens is these two brothers, they're twins, they get in a big argument, Jacob and Esau. And Esau's really, really mad, so Jacob's like, well, maybe if I leave for a little bit, he'll cool off. And his mom says, okay, you can stay at my brother's. And he's like, okay, I'll leave. And so he does. And his uncle has two daughters, Rachel and Leah. And he's like, ooh, Rachel's pretty. And so he goes to his uncle and says, I'll work 7 years for her. So his uncle says, okay, that's fine. And he works 7 years, but he finds out on his wedding day, his father-in-law gave him Leah. And he's like, what happened? This is not who I proposed to. And so they have this big talk. And then after that, Jacob says, okay, I understand. Because his father-in-law said, okay, it's our custom, the oldest daughter can't be married before the youngest, or vice versa. And so what they did was, Leah married Jacob, and then Rachel and Jacob got married. So in other words, to make a long story short, you have this brother marrying his two cousins, and what happens was, they've been married for a couple years, kind of an awkward family situation, to say the least. And then Rachel finds out she can't have kids. And back then, culturally, that was a woman's worth. That was what her status in society was determined by. And so she goes, talks to Jacob, says, okay, I'll give you my maidservant. She can have children for me. Jacob's like, okay. And then Leah doesn't have children for a while. And so she does the same thing. So now you have four women and one guy who is very silent in the Bible. He doesn't say a whole lot about this. And they actually have a very interesting conversation between Leah and Rachel, and it's in Genesis 30, verses 14 is where it starts. And at the time of the wheat harvest, Reuben went out and found some mandrake plants in a field and brought them to his mother Leah. Rachel said to Leah, give me some of your son's mandrakes. But Leah replied, wasn't it enough that you've taken away my husband? Would you take away my son's mandrakes too? All right, Rachel said, he may sleep with you tonight in exchange for your son's mandrakes. So verse 16, when Jacob came in from the fields that evening, Leah went out to meet him and said, you must sleep with me because I paid for your services with my son's mandrake. So he had marital relations with her that night. And it ends there. So as you can see, this is very awkward. But I looked because I was curious, what on earth would be worth trading a night with your husband for some weeds? And I'm like, it's like a drug deal or something. And it turns out, mandrakes, it's a natural estrogen. It was believed back then to help women get pregnant because they didn't have the medicine we do. And so Rachel was desperate to fulfill what her purpose in society was. And so despite all the awkwardness that was in this situation, all the mistakes, I definitely think there are things we can learn from this. And I think there's three main things. We can't take matters into our own hands. Because when we start thinking, oh, I know better, I can do this better myself, we limit what God can do in our lives and what He wants to do through us because we get in the way. We say, oh, yeah, I can do that. But instead of asking God, what would you want me to do? We say, okay, I can do that. But really, He has something so much better than what we could plan. Jeremiah 29:11 says, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a future and a hope. He wants to use us, but sometimes we end up limiting ourselves. And then, don't make things worse than they already are. We can sometimes, once we take things into our own hands, prolong an issue that's going on. We can complicate it more than it needs to be. And then lastly, allow God to use the situation for His good. Like I was saying earlier, He has something so much greater for us if we let Him use our goals, our dreams, our visions. We let Him take control of that, then we can be used by Him in a way that we didn't think was possible. We serve a God that, I mean, He created the universe, the stars. He forgave us of our sins. He can do anything through us that He wants. He can give us our dreams, give us our goals, help us find that purpose in life if we let Him do that. So I just want to encourage you to think, okay, maybe I'm trying to do this on my own. What does God want to do through me? So I just want to encourage you to think about tonight, and thank you.
Awesome job. Junior high human video, you are next. Go ahead and line up. So I am so proud of this team. I believe the average age of this team is somewhere around 13, 14. So this is a very young group of students. For many of them, this is the very first time they've ever did any kind of human video, anything like this. So I am just so proud of the work they've done. They are incredible. So I hope you enjoy.
I vow to fiercely love you in all your forms, now and forever. I promise to never forget that this is a once-in-a-lifetime love. And to always know in the deepest part of my soul that no matter what challenges might carry us apart, that we'll always find a way back to each other.
Meeting a teen girl online is actually pretty easy. Most of the girls are usually so insecure and desperate for attention.
Attention from older guys is totally flattering. They're so much more mature and understanding than the guys my
age. Age actually works to my advantage. They like to brag to their friends that they're dating an older guy, so I just play along and pretend I'm really interested
in the same things I am. If you really care about each other, there's nothing wrong with
meeting them is the goal. Once I get them out of their house, well, that's when things get really interesting.
Say something, I'm giving up on you. I'll be the one if you want me to. Anywhere I would have followed you. At all. will stumble and fall. I'm still learning to love, just starting to crawl. Say something, I'm giving up on you. I'm sorry that I couldn't get to you. Anywhere I would have followed you. Will swallow my pride. You're the one that I love, and I'm saying goodbye.
Good job. I'm so proud of them. Those are some very tough situational issues to deal with. Unfortunately, sex trafficking and Obviously, broken homes is something students are faced with, not just in the cities, but even in the country areas. So, up next, we have a drum solo. Oh, snap. Yep, that's right. Drum solo performed by Bailey Wolf. 1 second, no problem. So, Pastor Jordan and I worked with the JV team. Have you ever tried convincing... Saul, how old are you? You're 16? Convincing a 16-year-old, I need you to act like you just got a divorce. I know, seriously, bro, I need pain. And, I mean, I got to compliment him so much. He knocked it out of the park. You know what I'm saying? Great job. Take your time. I think that's the struggle with drama and human video in general. You have to embody what your character's feeling. Whether you connect with it at all or not, you have to, and that's what makes it great. Our kids are doing a phenomenal job. This young lady, I am so proud of. She has come so far with music and with drums. She's phenomenal. I cannot wait to see where she's going to end up even in 2 more years, let alone 10 or 20. The sky is the limit. I could not be more proud of her, and I know she's going to bless you with this.
We'll be right back.
Yeah. Good job. So come here for a second. So I got to stand right here for a sec. So I got to explain something real quick. This drum kit is set up for a man that's 6 feet tall. It's 2 inches taller than me. See a problem with this? Great job. Great job. Great work. Oh, forgot my paper. What? All right, up next, we have Daniel Coleman with a spoken word. Daniel is another one of my seniors.
I lose you this year, dude. I can't do it. I know.
You have no idea how emotional this is. Okay, all right.
God. Limitless. Limitless is our God and his power. So what you're going through can be changed even in your darkest hour. Your limited vocabulary of do's and don'ts, hoping you're not just a statistic, stewing in the pot, becoming a roast. You're so drunk off of your own pride that you don't even know who or what is on your side. I tell you, it's Jesus. He's right there beside you so that when you don't know what to do, he will help you push through. My God is a loving God whose love is limitless. Let me give you some definitions of limitless. Infinite, unlimited, never-ending, and perpetual. God made you the way you are, but let me tell you, he didn't make no homosexual. He made you for more. I know, I was right there too, failing every night, thinking I could never get through. All these empty nights lying awake here in bed, after I thought I saw a light at the end of the tunnel, it got worse. I felt bruised and broken, used and hated. It felt like I was only doing it for my own self-pleasure. It was a war within. I literally tore myself up inside, not turning to him. I tried to hide it, saying it's okay that I'm fine, but I still felt bad, thought of myself as a no-good swine. At this point, I was done. I couldn't be no better. It was like being the little boy at the deep end of the pool, drowning and confused and not knowing what to do, but all I knew was I needed God's grace and mercy, his holy shampoo. I ran long enough to know that I needed help, because obviously I couldn't help myself. All I needed to do was look up and remember that he's got me, even though I knew I was unworthy. I've had my ups and downs. I strive to be more like him, even when I feel like everything is lost and forgotten. But let me tell you, through pain and suffering comes grace and recovery. He only lets you go through something to make you stronger, so whatever the enemy throws at you, you'll be able to conquer. Now that I finally knew I'd been forgiven, I now boast in my weakness. His love is for all. He picks up all of the brokenness of us in grace and in love. His love is enough, enough for all. He's trying to get to you, but you refuse him, and you put him on a shelf. You act like you know everything, and you only trust yourself. I tell you, his love is for all. Don't think that you're alone. He can change you and reshape you just like he did for Paul. God is all the traits of love, and he's got an unlimited supply. He took our death, our blame, our sin, and he wiped it all away. And then he put his grace, love, and mercy on display. So believe me when I say, you can be saved in Jesus' name.
Awesome. Love you, bro. So proud of that guy. I think he could be a pastor if he wanted to. He didn't even hear me. I'll have to let him know that. Up next, we have what is called Guys R Us. Now sit back, fasten your seatbelts, make sure your shoes are tied. This is a large group human video. And there's no words. Not human video, this is spoken drama. There's no words for what you're about to see, so enjoy.
No!
nation of America cry and curl us back to Canada.
Canada!
Hey!
My ears, they're bleeding.
This is why Jesus wept.
Enough said.
Amen. Guys, we should try. Call me maybe.
Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy, but here's my number, so call me maybe. It's hard to look like. At you, baby, but here's my number, so call me maybe.
Guys, I don't think we'll be getting any calls if we try that.
Nobody ever calls me. Hashtag forever alone.
I think I lost all inspiration after listening to that song.
We'll get this.
Wait, guys, what about Wrecking Ball?
Guys, I feel really dumb looking at all these songs. We obviously need some Jesus in our music.
Yeah, guys, we're looking in all the wrong places trying to find our inspiration. These songs have only been famous for a short period of time, but God has been famous forever.
Yeah, good point. I can't even believe I thought Miley Cyrus would be a good idea.
Stupid!
What's wrong with you? What a moron.
Idiot.
Gee, thanks for the sympathy.
I think I have a good idea already. Let's go talk about it over lunch. I'm starving.
Will there be ham?
Yes, I have ham, I hope. Let's go.
Cause it ain't no lie, baby. Bye, 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 bye.
I told you there were no words. I can remember working with them and I was like, you guys want to do what? Okay. All right, in the final showcase of the night, this is our last. I just forgot that my wife is pinch hitting in this. Should be good. All right, this is the large spoken drama performed by Girls Are Us. So enjoy.
Ever after.
Okay,
Wasn't this good, guys? Would you give everyone a hand again, please? Love you guys. At this moment, I would like to hand out all of the awards that were given at Fine Arts. So if you please can hang out just for a few more minutes, I just want to honor each one of these students. I would also like to honor the coaches and have them come up to stage. If I could have Brittany Harrison, Bruce Harrison, please give them a hand. They did a lot of work with this group. Krista Campbell, would you please come up? Krista has, when I say relentless, there's no better description for Pastor Krista. She has been awarded nicknames such as Drill Sergeant Krista or Drill Sergeant Campbell. But you know what? The results speak for themselves. I'm very proud of her team. Would Hunter Flinchball please come up? I'm so proud of this young man. This was the first year that he wasn't able to participate in Fine Arts, and he dearly loves it. And he worked very closely with me and my wife for the JV team. And Paige Miller, would you please come up? Paige is the script writer for the large human video. And without her, it just wouldn't have been what it was. So I'm so thankful for her. Would you take that? So, you guys ready? When you guys come up, I want you to stay up here because most of you will be getting more than one, so just hang out, and then at the end, we'll clap really loud. All right, Cody Piercy. Cody Piercy, that was for Human Video Ensemble. Please stand over here, buddy. Courtney Piercy. Large Human Video Ensemble. Great job. Tanner Campbell. Large Human Video. This guy was the back, him and Cody, you guys were the backbones of the Human Video for the JV team. Seriously, I tell them this. I'm like, if we didn't have you, it would crumble, literally. And they're just like, yeah, you're right. Wendy Campbell, Large Human Video. Wendy is dealing with a hurt leg tonight. They're keeping a smile on, so proud of her. Jenna Taylor, awesome work, Large Human Video. Saul Shockey, Large Human Video. Come on, guys, let's keep it moving. So proud of you, buddy. Christian Shockey, Large Human Video. These guys did such a phenomenal job. So proud of them. Serenity Miller, Large Human Video. Leslie Nestor, Large Human Video. Good job. Bailey Wolf, Large Human Video. Leslie Nestor, Vocal Ensemble. There we go. Brianna Nestor, Vocal Ensemble. Great job. Bailey Wolf, Percussion Solo. Can we scoot down just a little? Leslie Nestor, Piano Solo. Look at, you know, you can have like a whole section of your room like for this now. Madison Campbell, Digital Photography. Oh, she's not up here yet. Jordan Wolf, Digital Photography. Yeah, buddy. Jordan is going to Nationals with his photography. I'm so proud of him. Good job, buddy. Brianna Nestor, Digital Photography. Excellent work.
All right, next we have Miss Ashley Harris for Drama Solo. I definitely know I'm not getting you a pet for Christmas. Yes. Miss Madison Campbell for Drama Solo. There you are. We've got Haley McCusker for dramatized quoting. That was a large portion of the scripture that you had memorized, so bravo, props to you. Daniel Coleman, spoken word. Miss Ashley Harris for her book chapter, which is hanging over there if you'd like to take a peek at that. So Miss Ashley Harris. And Miss Ashley Harris for her poetry, which as well is up over there for you to read.
All right. Y'all got to come to me. I'm not walking to you. Okay. This one is for the large group Puma Video Senior High. So first one we have is Eli Barr. Eli. Madison Campbell. Thank you. I kind of forced him this year to do it. Aren't you glad I did? Yep. All right. Madison Campbell. There you go. Daniel Coleman. Ashley Harris, behind me. Zoe Harris, I know she's here somewhere. There she is. Yeah, Haley McCusker, right behind me. Amelia Miller. This is another senior, last year girl. Nicholas Miller. Yay. There you are. Couldn't even tell you, you're losing your voice. They made fun of me a lot this through practices. Yes. Brianna Nestor. There you are.
Okay, next up is the small drama ensemble. This was your Tweedle Goobers. So we have Daniel Coleman, Nicholas Miller, Wild Man Nick, thank you, Leslie Nestor, and Brianna Nestor. Good job, guys.
I may be the sergeant because I talk the loudest, and I'm the sternest and the strictest, and well, anyway. But I have to say that Brittany is the brains and the anointing behind that large group human video. She is the one who comes up with the idea, and I'm just the one who's nice and bossy and makes sure it gets done. But honestly, I want to thank Brittany. I love working with her. We've done it a few years now, and I absolutely love it, and I'm so thankful God has anointed her in that way. Also, for Tweedle Goobers, Bruce doesn't want to take much glory for this, but he wrote 95% of Tweedle Goobers. So I just have to say that. All right, this is for the girls. Large group drama ensemble of all the princesses. So here we go. Zoe Harris. She did not get to do tonight because she actually was on a school trip and she just got in, but she has done an absolutely great job. Leslie Nestor. Ashley Harris. Madison Campbell. Amelia Miller, you did great. Haley McCusker, Brianna Nestor, Serenity Miller, and Serenity took Zoe's place tonight in the large group human video, and she did awesome, so thank you, Serenity. Bailey Wolf. And Courtney Piercy.
For visual art, two-dimensional, we have Zoe Harris. In short sermon, senior, we have Madison Campbell. In songwriting, Ben Bush.
Okay, and this is for the large drama ensemble. This is the Wrecking Ball Company, and I just want to know where the anointing came for that. Just wondering. Christian Shockey? Nicholas Miller?
You be nice.
Daniel Coleman? Eli Barr? Some people like the limelight. Saul Shockey.
So I hope you all can see that we as a church are blessed. Can you please give everyone one more hand?